Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about the new topic, that is a pest management. In this pest management, step by step we are going to discuss about the different aspects associated to the pest management, that is the number of the pest, their life cycle, up to the control measures. But when we think about the pest, it creates the problems to the agriculture field, to the human welfare, their property. It shows that indirectly or directly, which loss their property. And as per the definition, the pest is any organism which occurs in a large number and conflict with man's welfare, convenience, as well as the profit here. That is, as the population of an organism increases due to the favorable climatic condition, or it may be the ample of the food available in that area, and as per the population when increases, certain aspects which create the problems in case of the man's welfare and loss certain their economy. In another word, the pest is any organism that is harmful to our health and properties, including the crop as well as the livestock. Now, suppose this is the number of the individuals of a species which lives in a particular environment. Due to certain reasons, it becomes the pest. When the population which is increases, and when the population increases because of the certain reasons which are present here. What are the reasons which are associated due to which that organism which is converted into the pest? First is the deforestation. Due to the cutting of the trees and that land which is used for the cultivations, pests which are present in that forest, it moves toward the cultivated area. And as the availability of the food, they increase the population and which create the problems. Improved agronomic practices. This also the very important point, where increase the nitrogen fertilizers, closer plantings, as well as use of granular insecticides, which create the severe problems in the agriculture field. Another point, that is excess use of the insecticides. Here, as the use of the insecticides, due to which the enemies which attacks on the pest killed by these insecticides, and this condition is favorable for that pest to increase their population. Another point, accidental introduction of the pest, which comes from the foreign countries with the food materials which are imported, and when they introduce in our country, they create the severe problems, not to that of the crop, but as well as the another crops also. Number of the accidental pests which are introduced in our country, as the potato tuber moth, diamondback moth, as well as the cottony cushion scales. Another one is the monoculture, that is another reason due to which continuous cultivation of the same crop in that area, which is the favorable situation for that pest, and as their population continuously increases, which create the problems. Food storage in the large scale, this also the reason due to which a species or an organism which becomes the pest. introduction of the new varieties and the crop affect the so many agriculture crops also. Urbanization that is associated to the deforestation or cutting of the trees for the cultivation, industrialization or even the urbanization, and at that time when the pest or the organisms which are present, it moves toward the another area, and where the favorable situation is present, that organism converted into the pest. And the last aspect is the domestic nature. Just we provide the food materials in the form of the grains to the pigeon, wasted food materials to the pigs, to the dogs, and they comes in that area continuously because they get easily available food materials, and it may cause the nuisance, disease or inconvenient situation which created by such animals here. These all are the reasons due to which the species or an organism which becomes the pest. Now, the types of the pest. The first one, that is on the basis of the morphological differences, these are the different pests. They are variable in their morphological natures. That insects, which is the severe pest, and around 15% to 20% that loss in the production of the agriculture field caused by the insect. Nematodes also affect the roots, stem as well as flowering part of the plants. Weeds also cause the severe damage and carried about the 12% to 13% loss of the crop production. Certain microorganisms, that is a plant pathogens, which also affect the productivity of the agriculture field. Molluscans, among which the slugs, snails, also attack the roots or the flowering buds of the plants. Mites also cause the severe damage and decline the productivity of the agriculture field. And last one, the many vertebrates, it may be the fishes, that birds, even though the mammals, certain reptiles also, certain amphibians also, which affect directly or indirectly the productivity of the agriculture field as well as the mankind welfare or even though their properties. In case of the types of the pest, that on the base of the nature, intensity or the frequency of the occurrence of the pest. The first one, that is a regular pest. That regular pest which occurs every crop season and causes yield losses, which frequently occurs on the crop. The examples are the rice stem borer, brinjal fruit and shoot borer. Another one, that is sporadic or occasional pest. In that sporadic or the occasional pest, a pest whose population remains low and insignificant for long period of the time. They increase damaging levels due to favorable climatic conditions or depletion of the natural enemies. That is, depends on the favorable condition or there is no any natural enemies, they becomes the pest. Certain examples, that is locust, we know about that in our country, especially the Madhya Pradesh and Vidarbha region, the severe damage which is caused by the millions of that pest, that is a locust. Mango stem borer, hairy caterpillars, these are the certain examples. Next is the seasonal pest. As per the name seasonal pest, it means that comes in a season every year. Some prefer the warmer months due to having a better environment to breed in and of course feed. That is, as per the favorable condition for the multiplication or for the reproduction, March up to the May, that is the better environment for their reproduction. While some of the species, especially in our home also, or even the business area, which has the favorable condition, that starting from the August up to the December, January month, that period which is very effective for the reproduction. Certain examples, that is red hairy caterpillar, which is observed on the groundnut, and this is the mango hoppers, which are very minute, and thousands of that hoppers, that is a bug, which suck the sap of that leaves. Next is the persistent pest, which occurs on the crop throughout the year and is difficult to control. They are typically small in size. They are mobile, that is move from one place to the another place, and has the chances, that is a more damage, and have a high reproductive potential. That pest may transmit the disease as well as injure the high value crop. Examples: chili thrips, mealybug, on the guava, codling moths, corn earworms. These are the certain examples associated to the persistent pest. Now, the next one, potential pest. In this potential pest, a pest that could cause significant economic loss if not kept under the control by their natural enemies. It will take advantage of a delayed crop emergence or herbicide applications. That is, when the crop emergence, which is delayed due to the natural calamities, or by the farmers, it may be delayed the applications of the herbicide, and at that time, that pest whose population increases and continuously which attack on the crop of that area. Certain examples, that is a fruit tree red spider mite, Spodoptera litura, and this one is the black cutworms, and alfalfa weevil also. Next is the key pest. Here, many insects whose population are always above the damage threshold. It means that population which is higher and which cause the severe damage to the agriculture crop. They cause severe damage to the crop. Example, chickpea pod borer, which is polyphagous and cause the severe damage. Cotton bollworm, diamond back moth, sugarcane borer, these are the certain examples is of the key pest. Next is the major pest. Major pests are those that cause damage over the 10%. Several insect groups attack the flowers, fruits, leaves, and the branches of the agriculture crop. The most important pest which affecting the agriculture production is the Lepidoptera fruit borers. In addition to that, certain examples are the cotton jacets, white flies, along with that rice stem borer, bark borers, scale insects are the major insect pest. Now, the minor pest. This pest which causes the damage between the 5 to 10%. In the major pest, the damage more than the 10%. But here, up to the 5 to 10% damage caused by the pest, basically that pest known as the minor pest. It damages below the 5% are tolerable and often negligible. These pests are localized to a certain area. Example, that is a cotton stainer, number of the species of the thrips, mites, rice hispa, ash weevils are the minor pest. Dear friends, today we discussed about the different aspects of the pest, that is definition, different reasons due to which become the pest, as well as different types of the pest. Our next topic is the pest of the cotton. Thank you.